Hello everyone and welcome to your Epicenter European Qualifier. We have our next part of the qualifier, Teen Spirit going up against Polarity. If you don't know anything about this tournament so far, go to joinDOTA.com. You can click on the coverage page or it'll take you to the Epicenter page and you'll see that we are in the lower bracket round two when we have Teen Spirit going up against Polarity. Polarity, who are the team that 2-0'd out Na'Vi in a very convincing fashion. And our later game today will be DB. It is the Danish Bears going up against Vega, who 2-1'd against LC last night in a interesting display of Dota. A man, of course, I know he absolutely loves CIS Dota, so when I asked him to cast this and he agreed to do it, I was very surprised. It is OG's Moon Meander. Welcome to Teen Spirit versus Polarity, man. Smooth Moon. Have you actually walked away? I've unmuted his mic. I think he's muted his own mic. Is my only...
Wait, can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you.
Oh, sorry.
Well done, Moon. Well done.
Yeah, I muted my mic. I forgot to unmute it. Well, look at this. The Russians, man. They rush so fast. It's insane. It's like barely 30 seconds and like 3 heroes are picked already.
Oh, Goblack doesn't like to waste time. He hates wasting time. Which is funny because we're waiting for Team Spirit today.
Of course he doesn't hate wasting time. If you watch the Team Spirit intro video where you see Goblack running all the time, Radiant team back. You haven't watched it yet? I recommend, highly recommend you watch the team intro for Team Spirit into Shanghai Major.
I think only you could have actually Radiant connected the two of those back. Things together. Maybe they just thought like Goblack was a lanky kind of guy, so obviously he's a long distance runner.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, you have to ban the Goblack Chun and Enchantress. You have to, and they did it.
Yeah. 10 seconds remaining. And while the Earth Spirit and the IO also go out against Polarity. But this leads through the hero who I've been seeing probably more than any other hero in the mid. It's just the OD. He's either banned in the first phase or picked in the first phase every single time.
It's a strong hero because it's hard to lose middle to him. I mean, it's less to lose middle with him. Like, it's just like a mid dominator, you know? Like, it's hard to gank him because of his Astro. It's hard to kill him. He's so tanky and fast, and it's so easy to kill with him. And he transitions really well into the mid-game carry and the late-game carry, so like he's just a really good mid. So that's the reason why Team Spirit picked Puck in the first two, is just because Puck doesn't really lose his lane, per se, versus OD too. So it's like one of the more like passive options to dealing with OD lately, in pubs at least.
I think it was actually in the game against LC, they had exactly the same combination. It was the Puck versus the OD, and it was Baby Knight's OD. In that game, though, the Puck was actually, I think he was 5 times the CS of the OD at the 5-minute mark.
Oh, that's just the OD player being bad, honestly. That shouldn't have happened.
it didn't really end well that game, but... They were actually running still the same combo with the Prophet as well as the Puck. They're going to mix things up because the Drow was banned out by Lil. So obviously he knows that's a Team Spirit. They like to go for the early Drow pickup with it. And they've actually gone for the Spectre. A little bit more late game from Team Spirit.
I can see Team Spirit's strategy here already. It's the global strat where it's like A plus B or A plus C or B plus C is a kill. So like, let's say Puck Blinkhoys and Altis, Spectre Hans, that's a kill. Puck Blinkhoys Altis, Nature's Prophet TPs, that's a kill. Nature's Prophet TP Sprouts, Spectre Altis, that's a kill. So they're trying to have a lot of global presence, like a lot of pressure being put all across the map. But the weakness of their lineup I already see is they have really weak laning phase. Like they're really abusable so far.
Is that when you just get someone who... Well, do you want to actually get laning phase? Or do you want more control? Lion's still available in the pool for Teen Spirit. Is it something like that? Or
Lion is amazing here, but then again, you'd run into the problem of having Lion Witch Doctor. It's like a really awkward dual support. It's doable, but it's awkward, you know?
As opposed to just getting something more like a jungler at this point. Or someone that is capable of going into that jungle.
I mean, both the junglers are bad, except for Enigma, but... Then you're playing Enigma, it's kind of slow to play Enigma versus like Spectre Nature's Prophet. Enigma is good in the way that like they don't have a BKB disable yet, but if you pick Enigma here, they might just pick a BKB disable next. Like, they just make you pick a worthless hero to disable BKB like like a silencer or like glitch or some shit like that. And so you don't want to pick Enigma here.
Say hello to the Chaos Knight. This guy is appearing in so many of my games. He's at least in half of them. This early, you build Bracer into Armlet and then complete up the drums as well. Chaos Knight, he's been brutal in the lanes and brutal in fights.
Yeah, because Chaos Knight is early ass timing, which is like super good laning phase, and then you just kind of like takes over the game, and it's really hard for Chaos Knight to die to Spectre rotation as well. And I know for a fact that, you know, remember when Batman was spamming Spectre?
Yeah.
And he would hit like 8.7k at one point, and he would first pick Spectre. And sometimes, you know, you all pick you in the first pick, and enemy team's like, oh, it's Batman, I'm going to first pick his Spectre. How Batman counters it is Batman plays Chaos Knight. That's why they play Chaos Knight. I'm not even kidding. That's the counter to Spectre. The Batman's counter to Spectre. He's on hero. Chaos Knight.
That's actually awesome. There was one thing which happened with Polarity when they played their Chaos Knight against Na'Vi last night. They had no way to clean up the illusions of Chaos Knight. They ran both the OD and the Chaos Knight on the same side. And I'm worried the Team Spirit's going to have exactly the same problem. What is their AoE clear to get rid of these CK illusions remaining when they start getting tankier?
Yeah, CK was a really good pick here because Team Spirit only picked three of the cores. And like, it's not like the support's going to be like clear the support's not going to be like a godly hero that can suddenly like magically clear CK's illusions, you know?
Yeah, but that's what I was thinking. Something like Alliance, so you got like Drain as well as Hex to get rid of some of these illusions, but they went for the Oracle instead.
Yeah, that's a little bit weird. I would have went for Lion. Especially, like, since, like, now you can't really pick Lion, because now you have Lion Oracle, it's kind of awkward. Lion's always good, you know. There's never a situation where Lion's bad, I don't think.
Yeah.
Ogre.
What was the downsides about Lion that was always brought up? He's just, like, it takes a while before he gets a Blink Dagger. But then we saw him in combination. I can't remember who was running it, but they were just, they were either playing Tiny or Tusker with the Lion. And that was their way to just get him in. And they ran him as a sacked fifth.
Yeah. Sometimes people make the mistake of running the second line completely. I like the way, like, let's say you run it with Tusk, right? I like it when the Tusk gets, like, Arcane Boots Magic Stick in the first, and then doesn't buy any items, and then he gets Arcane Boots Magic Stick, maybe an Urn. And then when he gets those items, then you'd be like, hey, maybe you have to look at the game, and if you need more teamfight, the Tusk goes mech. You don't need more team fight, you need pick off, then the Tusk starts buying awards and Lion proceeds to get the blink. It's like balance with the supports.
So you actually draft to be dynamic in the game. Makes sense.
Yeah. Okay. They need a support on Spirit and they need an offlane on Polarity. You call the support pick, I will call the offlane pick.
My support pick is still the Lion for Team Spirit, even if they got the Oracle. The offlane are like, were you even going to pick a Timbersaw? Because Goblack, like, something has to have happened in some kind of scrim for him to ban that Timbersaw out.
Yeah, I can see that. Even, yeah. Timbersaw is just a good hero here, though. For Polarity, too. Remaining. But I don't know why. I never seen Timber so bad. I think, like...
Well, most people think they could just deal with him, right?
Yeah. I think they're going to pick Faces Void. It makes sense to pick Faces Void, honestly. Faces Void is so good as Puck.
Radiant team pick.
Fun dying. It's because... You look at Polarity's lineup, right? It's Chaos Knight Ogre in the third and fourth pick. Like, they, like, pretty much says, I'm all in the lanes, guys. I'm going to run you over in the first 5 minutes of the game. Especially when you pick an Ogre like that.
Is that when you just try and put like a big head against him? Like you push the Undying Oracle Spectre to the bottom lane and let Funnic have his fun on top?
10 seconds. No, I think you want to do that. I think you want... Oh, that's a really good pick, actually. They have no stuns. Also a really good pick. I think they just wanted to put Puck and Undying offlane, which is... they just provide Undying offlane together and then just like keep the support bottom, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you just bank on the dual lanes being enough. Is that really going to be enough, though, when you've got... Like, when Chaos Knight gets up in the levels and you've got Paralyzing Cask, I'm not seeing Goblin having enough presence there to actually stop it. As you said, like, they've got no stunts, they've got no real CC on Team Spirit.
You're right. But they kind of go offensive because it's Spectre. You don't really want to go offensive with Spectre.
Yeah. The other reason why I was thinking that is like, because then you bring in the Prophet, so you turn it into like a quad lane and you find kills early on. If Polarity are going to try and force the issue, can you force it back? But like, I can understand going against it because not many teams are running aggro anything these days. Like, it's like aggro dual lane and that's all.
Prepare for battle. I think what's going to happen is they're just going to... Yeah, Leo's already buying sentries. He has to. And Liam Ward. This is the desperation move that you need to do to play against the off lane that you're supposed to lose. You need Liam Ward. You need sentries and stuff. You need everything. You need to counter his ward, which is probably going to get countered because, you know, definitely a ward. No, he doesn't have a ward and Weaver. That's a mistake, I think.
I realize I haven't put your name in yet, and your name is actually longer than any other caster's name we have ever had. So I'm actually having to readjust the overlays just to fit you in, man.
Really?
Yeah.
What about Admiral Bulldog?
Well, he's actually no... Well, actually, that's not true. That's not true. Bulldog, I think, cast with me a very long time ago. 30 seconds. Like, we're talking years ago.
Yeah, Bulldog takes a lot of space.
Yeah.
Literally.
Bro. Dude, I want to see Bulldog go into like Flyers boot camp. He'll come out and just wreck your face.
That would never happen. We all know that.
The showdown.
Bulldog will not survive one day in Flyers boot camp, okay? Begins. Let's not kid ourselves here. Have you seen Moni Isaac? How big he is? His dad?
I've seen a couple of pictures, yeah.
Yep, his dad runs the bootcamp, and it's no joke. Apparently, Tao told me about it before.
You should really do that. Like, even if you're gonna make like an OG fly like video with Fly, just have like Fly's bootcamp. Who can survive out of all the Dota 2 pro players? Golden idea, right there. Enjoy.
Oh, Fnatic screwed up. You see that Treant's thing? He screwed up. He screwed up big time. Oh, not like this, Fnatic. He didn't do the Admiral Bulldog.
What, without the creep, without doing the skipping?
No, what you do, the Admiral Bulldog, is to actually summon, 4 Treants to pull the creep wave versus Witch Doctor.
Okay.
So when he uses the cast...
Phobos? Is Phobos dead? You know, with a Fairy Fire consumption? Illidan? Nope, he's got him. They set up with an Obs and Sentry. That was, just a simple, almost a full duration Fate's Edict. Always gonna fly, was just a fraction of a second off it. And Illidan with level 1 Spectral Dagger kills an off-lane Weaver, thanks to Vision Game.
That should never happen. I mean, that's just full boss misplaying, I'm sure of it. That's really big, because, like, Lil, who's supposed to be, like, I mean, who's always wanted to fly, he's dead.
They'll get revenge. He's going to phase Edict himself, Fortune's End himself a little bit further away, and with the consumption, it's still not enough. So Weaver will get some revenge, so good rotation from Lil.
Yeah, he needed punish top, and he knew that, because this lane is so punishable. Imagine if Weaver didn't feed First Blood and just waited like a minute, that happened, then like the game is kind of like over at that point. Not really over, but then they would get really punished for their picks. Really, really punished.
These guys are rotating so hard, now Goblack's up on top lane. Bottom tower is under attack. Well, it started as like a dual mid. Has now turned into a defensive tri-lane from Team Spirit against a Weaver, which they... have no real stuns over. Like, Fortune's Ends are on the controller.
You can't even call it control, honestly, because you have to, like, charge it up for so long.
Yeah. But the only reason Phobos died to it before is because he walked all the way through the Obs and Sentry Ward.
Yeah. Look at mid lane.
Yeah. Lil's not gonna get down, though.
Look at a fat ogre. How annoying is he? Look at him. Just look at him.
He's got no movement speed, but, like, they can... Wait, is Lil? He started the stuns twice. I was waiting for that critical timing when Iceberg missed his jaunt.
Yeah. You know, even though Fnatic screwed up in the first wave, he is 9 CS. He's playing so well right now in Fnatic.
So even when he screws up, he's still good?
Yeah, I don't know what happened. He just like screwed up, but he is 9 CS somehow versus that lane.
Well, the creep wave came underneath the tier 1 tower. So he was just able to farm underneath that. Yeah, Polarity lost control of it for a little bit.
Must have done something smart to lose control. I didn't catch it, but probably did something good.
I didn't see it either, but... Phobos? He's not really getting a lot of levels up on this top lane. Like, I suppose he's still level 3 compared to what he's up to. Like, up against. It's better than just feeding away. But what do you even want from this Weaver? Like, the Weaver, is levels really enough? Like, if it's a Beastmaster who's got Roar, I can understand that. But Weavers kind of need farm to be effective.
Was Beastmaster banned?
I don't think Beastmaster was even touched.
Wow. I think Beastmaster would have been better. Beastmaster
was left out. Darkseer was left out.
Darkseer is not that good because it's against Oracle. You're picking Darkseer into Oracle. But I would see like Void being okay just because it's just a puck. But I can see why they pick Weaver.
Phobos. Time again with. Nope. Thought they
might. Do you see how fast Oracle attacks? It's insane. You don't notice it until you play against it, you know?
I don't know if I'm Phobos though, if I'm really scared about an auto attack from an Oracle.
Oh, it adds up, mate. It adds up.
Iceberg is getting a little harassed. He's actually going to consume his Fairy Fire rather already and use Phase Shift. And TP support's coming in.
Yeah, they're being very annoying in the mid lane. You're still winning in CS though, the fuck, with this Ogre running middle. That's pretty good. I don't think much heroes can do that.
I love the way really always good. When a flyer brings Iceberg back up again. Three purifying flames to do it.
It's actually pretty smart.
He had no life anyway, so it wasn't really taking much away from him.
Yeah.
This Witch Doctor's been waiting for this moment on the bottom lane for a while. Paralyzing Cask, Malediction as well. And Funnick, well, he's going to sprint and attempt this TP out to safety, and he's going to make it. The Malediction tick won't do enough.
Every time you live as Nature's Prophet by doing that, it's so big because you TP back to base, you heal up full mana, full HP, and the enemy team has to regen up again. It's just really big.
Do you lose that much though if you're the CK at this point?
Like, you kind of do, because now you're half HP, force to use itself. So now any auto attack hits on you stays there.
This movement up the top from Team Spirit, it's always when a flyer was going, but I think he's too worried about what Afo is going to do to Iceberg.
I think they're just waiting on Team Spirit for Spectre hit level 6, and then they're going to get the ball rolling. Right now, Fennec's level 6 way faster than he should be. So all they need right now is Illidan hit level 6, and then this game will be like fast, like shock, like just like bam, 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 bam.
As opposed to two really kills fast. In 6 minutes.
Yep. Then we're gonna see our rushing game. Just wait.
Fnatic making a break for Roshan again with a Sprout. Does no one have a Tango? No one's gonna Tango, and Fnatic will actually cancel his TP out, realizing that they're just gonna leave him.
You're so cheeky, actually, Fnatic.
Well, he's got to impress you, man. After the tree into the start. Are they going mid?
They're going mid.
Yeah, here's the Prophet TP over. But the Dream Calls have been used. But defensive imprisonment from Afo makes it, like, impossible to do damage to him.
Yeah, they just... This is why this hero is so broken, honestly. Just like, hey guys, Astro, TP mid, guys. I'm getting ganged. Like, alright. Congratulations, you're a good player. Manage to Astro yourself.
I can self-cast.
Alright. Almost level 6 in Illidan. That's a mistake from Iceberg, I think. We're not waiting for Spectre level 6 for Coil. Now the timing's a little bit screwed up. Because you want to get your first kill of a Coil, not force TPs. And yeah, pretty much they just needed to wait. Because there's no way that mid's not a kill. The Spectre Haunt, they just profit out TP in. That was a kill for sure. Even if a defensive Astral.
You got Wrath up in 40 seconds then, and Dream Call in 20.
Yeah, that's the next timing.
But there's no other rotation coming. Like right now, you've got Goblack actually walking back to base because he's got no mana to speak of. Funnick still looks bunkered in on this bottom lane, and his mana also isn't really that great. As he summons these treants, you don't actually have Wrath of Nature at the moment.
He needs to summon them though, because he needs to make sure that the tower doesn't take too much damage and scout the bottom moon. It's fine. He's gonna heal now, I think. Oh, he's not. Funnick, please.
All right. He wants the experience.
It's not worth it. Because you're just wasting time.
Suppose he could always just buy a TP scroll and come back anyway. But is this, considering the amount of money he's got, is this going to be a Midas Funnick?
Yeah, probably. They have ulties up. What are they doing? They're just sitting there. This is what Polarity wants.
Time to farm up a CK's armlet. Time for OD to actually gain more and more levels.
Yeah, pretty much. Actually, this is not what Polarity wants. It's for to get one kill in 8 minutes. They want more than this, but...
Well, they might have an opportunity up on top lane. The Ignite's going to hit both Fly and Illidan, but Lil didn't get in the stun.
Yeah. Polarity doesn't want the game to hit this point of getting enough kills, but if Team Spirit's actually just going to do nothing, which is very rare for Russians to do nothing, like, it's actually very rare, then, like...
Oh, here's a Spectral Haunt. Are they going to go mid? It is. They're on Afo, but there's your defensive imprisonment. But they did use a Dream Call, and Tombstone's also down, but Afo... Well, as you said, it was a guaranteed kill, but the Luz always want to fly on the top lane to DK Phobos in the meantime. He'll time-lapse off all the damage that's done. It ends up being a one-for-one trade, but the mid for a support.
That's a mistake from, what's his name? Afro Ninja. Because he saw gold black TP middle. He literally saw gold black TP middle. Like, in full vision. Radiant, like, if that doesn't scream that, hey, I'm gonna gank your ass, then I don't know what does. Because all he needs to do is, in that case, when the support's middle, is don't lay in middle by yourself. You need a support sitting behind you, otherwise it's jungle.
Waiting for Phonic to have a play for that, but he didn't have Wrath of Nature. They had a crack at Phobos and will force him all the way back to base.
Yeah.
Alright, so in this game, Phonic actually ended up deciding going for the drums, so we'll get more of a combat style Nature's Prophet.
That's better to get drums, honestly. You're not gonna like go Midas and go late game versus like three carries. Weaver, Chaos Knight, OD, I think you just need to get a kill with every ultimate and win the game through that way.
Should he actually come in with it with bigger control? Because the only reason why I was thinking Midas is because he may need something like a Scythe Vice. For a team with so little stuns, they need something.
I mean, they need to have a Vice, but...
Is Orca going to be enough for this early stage?
They need to have a Vice. They need a lot of items, but at the same time, like, those are, like, way later. I think they have to, like, win the game fast. I mean, like, just apply a lot of pressure early, and if he goes Midas and stuff, it's bad. Because, like I said, they're playing as a triple core lineup. They need to punish the triple core.
Always going to fly almost dead.
Yeah.
Well, Phobos decided to bail out. He already did the damage he was looking for. Just to drop Always Wanna Fly that little bit lower. And Lil's preparing. They Spectral Haunt. The Observer Ward that was planted down a couple of minutes ago by Goblack helps them set up for this. Phonic actually TP'd in over for this nice poke. He'll jawn away, but the 4 second stun. Say goodbye. You can actually trade an Ogre for a Puck.
Yeah, that's good. Anyway, and people will be like, but my carry rotated. Well, meanwhile, the Mishokta's farming bottom, so it's all good in the hood.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of experience down here, too. Bring in the Death Ward. Yeah. Phonic, now he actually wants to have a crack at him. He's going to go directly into the Death Ward. And Phonic, the TP out, it's not going to happen. 1 second,
really well
even getting that crit just to put the final nail in the coffin.
That's a really good play. That's a CK's armlet, by the way. That's really big. Look at net worth. Oh my goodness, CK is so far.
Yeah. He's had so much space on this bottom lane.
Yeah.
Like, Phonic may have influenced the other lanes, but this bottom lane seems to just be pretty much Parshas.
Yep. I don't think like he should be bottom anymore after getting a kill like that.
Oh,
that was
Iceberg's
really good.
In trouble. Iceberg's actually in a lot of trouble. He's gonna orb himself away, but the imprisonment means he can't do it. Yeah. That's actually such a horrible time for a Puck. He'll Dream Coil. He's got Orb in 1 second time, but OD just drops the ulti. With a Haste Rune, there was no way that Puck was going to be able to outrun Afo either.
Look at OD, man. Look at it here. So much skill. So much skill. Just right click. So much skill. I can't take it. What a good player.
There's a couple of heroes who are like that. It's not just OD, bro. remember the Zeus claims, like, all you gotta do is press R and you've won the game.
Yeah, Zeus requires positioning. And look at OD's skill, by the way. Level 3 Astro.
Yeah, what is with that?
I don't know. Look at Fnatic, bottom, just blocking. He's dead again on Fnatic, which is, like, horrible. Because he's level 9. He's level 9, he's dying. he was same level as Chaos Knight. Now Chaos Knight is almost level 11 because he's had 2 kills in a row. That's like, and Witch Doctor's level 8. That's really not good. You know, when I feed, right? At least I feed when I'm low level, you know? So it doesn't really matter. When I'm like level 9, I don't die anymore.
Gonna be more defensive. But maybe he's also feeling pressure. We know, well, we saw from Polarity in their Law Bracket round 1 match what they do with this Chaos Knight. The second he hits level 11 and has the mana for it, they just trigger Phantasm and push down buildings. Like, they don't even wait for the fights to use Phantasm, they just use it to take out the early tier 1000s and if they can push to the tier 2s as well.
Dude, this Chaos Knight just bought an armlet. He's 150 gold from Crumbs. Alright, yeah, this guy's getting too fat, really.
Afo being initiated on. Quick fortunes in, but Afo imprisoned up. The Oracle, so there's no instant nuke power coming out, but there's a lot of chase. And Iceberg will commit the Dream Call for this. Afo will be going down.
Yeah, he went top route with no vision. That's why he died.
That Goblack dies in the meantime. Pasha's actually locked in by the undead minions until Witch Doctor killed off the Tombstone.
Do they just like keep running bottom for no reason and feeding? Yep, that's what they're doing actually.
Yep.
Now he has drums.
So with the drums up on a CK, you've got Phobos who's actually got really, like, his survivability is ridiculous. He actually went for a Vanguard to go with his Ring of Aquila. He's going to try and kill off always on a fly here. When I say try, he's going to have to wait a little bit longer thanks to False Promise, but the Death Ward. Okay, always on a fly is most definitely dead. And Funnick's still got the bug on the back of him. He's finally going to shrug off.
Honestly, Phobos is the boss.
Illidan.
This is the boss build.
Illidan. With a multicast from Lil, they can try and kill him off at the moment. Phobos still has Shikuchi, he's going to go for again with the Scarabs. As Illidan jumps into the tree line, his Spectral Dagger's going to last a little bit longer. Man, Phobos is so damn slow with no boots.
Yeah, but look how tanky he is. Yeah. He's actually owning right now. It's a good build.
This reminds me, like, wasn't it, it was Black who used to do this all the time? Like, even back in Dota 1, he just refused to go boots. Like, you'd be like a 15-minute Weaver, and he still wouldn't buy boots.
Yep. Doesn't Black play support now?
I don't know what... does Black play in any team now? Like, for all the roster shuffles, like, I know he got picked up in one team, but then I think there was a... Like, the false rumor that team then disbanded. But there's been... Yeah, they haven't played in any tournaments that I've seen.
No, because they haven't... They're not able to play in any tournaments, because they can't. They're not signed up. I don't know. They need to be in open qualifiers, basically. Well, and he's an adventurer. He's playing support. He's playing a 5, and he got. Yeah, that's what he's doing right now. That's crazy.
One of the best farmers in Europe, and he's in a fifth role. Yeah, that doesn't feel right.
Maybe, you know, he's just doing him. You know, sometimes people just wanna. Try something new. You never know what's gonna happen.
Maybe. But at the same time, what always brought a smile to Black's face was the ability to come out after 20 minutes with more farm than anybody else. That's what made him a very, very happy man.
That is true.
Say hello to Urn. And a lot of force coming in from Polarity on top. I say force. He's still this Weaver. He picks up the Glove of Haste before even getting boots.
Smoke, yeah. They're gonna smoke top and defend that, which I disagree with, because, I mean, like, yeah, it's pretty obvious of a smoke, honestly.
Polarity's already falling back. Meanwhile, CK is getting closer to his BKB.
Yeah, this should kill the CK.
Actually, is it even worthwhile going for a BKB on the CK? We already talked about how minimal the stuns are from Team Spirit.
It's going yes and why, dude.
Yeah. SMY or Manta?
SMY or Manta?
Because I could see him leaning towards Manta, because I'm still not feeling Team Spirit's ability to clean up illusions.
Manta is decent, but SMY is more fun to play CK with, because you know, you're so fast. Like, zoom, zoom, zoom.
Nah, they couldn't get there in time. They're trying to get the sun from Lil.
Alright, they need to take some towers for Nature's Prophet.
That TP, do they see it? Wish Doctor doesn't have his paralyzing cast at the moment, trying to actually go for the malediction, but Iceberg dodged it with a nicely timed phase shift. And the TP out from Lil, successful enough, so Spectral Haunt's gonna drop, and so is Dreamcoil. And
that's
what you
really
get for
big.
It is a Witch Doctor.
And they're gonna get mid tower. which is what they need badly.
Let's effort wants to try and go for a play. They're TPing in the Weaver at the moment. An Iceberg slowed up by the Rod of Atos. He'll blink himself away to safety now. The tower still has to go down to the Oracle. But Phobos on the chase of Illidan, because he's so tanky, he knows he doesn't have enough damage. Because he also built a very tanky kind of style. But the CK, say hello to Phantasm, and say goodbye to Goldblack. He's on the run here. They need another controller, and a 4 second stun will do exactly that. But 20 stolen intelligence, Iceberg also in trouble, getting realityed out, but Afo read the play perfectly. Drops the ult in his head, saw where the ult was going. There was just no safe port for Team Spirit to go to.
That's fine for Team Spirit. I know they all die for that, but they really needed to take some towers, be it suiciding or whatever.
Does Funnick get... Yeah, Funnick's got that. Stick charges, Funnick. Funnick?
No, he didn't get it.
He didn't get it, now they're actually going to lose their tier 2 tower as well in mid. Not okay, as much he could have done to stop that.
They need to... That's actually really actually not worth it for Spirit to lose his tower. Yeah, that was not worth it. I changed my mind. Now, this is just Nature's Prophet effect. No, remember he died twice bottom? If he didn't die twice bottom and actually just did what Nature's Prophet is supposed to do, which is you just collapse on your lanes and get kills like TP top or TP mid if it does and kill the Weaver and take a tower. This is exactly what he's supposed to do, but instead he just sat in his lane and died twice. Yeah, he is 104 CS, but, you know, he only took one tower, two towers now, but at what cost?
Could it just be the mindset as well, like the fact that he wanted to get the Orchid and just didn't have the money for it?
He still needed to, like, TP the lanes and help other lanes. That's why he's so good, because that's why he picked Prophet. The hero can is literally broken. You just TP to global TP to anywhere on the map. That's broken.
Remember what it used to be? You can only TP where there was vision.
Really?
Yeah, that was the older version of Nature's Prophet teleportation.
Is that a Dota 1 thing?
That was a Dota 1 thing. That was, because you would then send, you'd be able to make a flying courier from the 0 minute mark. So you'd make a flying courier, and you'd send it all the way around the edge of the map into the enemy well, like just on the edge of it so you could see, and then you'd TP the Prophet in. So he'd go for courier snipes doing that. That's what you used to have to do to actually do like base courier sniping. That was when there was no protection. You had shields on couriers and not fountain protection for couriers.
That's some old school shit.
Yeah, it really is, man. Say goodbye to Roshan. It belongs to Team Spirit.
That's because we're Team Spirit. Do you actually do Rosh so fast and dying? Because the damage amp works with his ultimate, so he Rosh takes 20% more damage. And Inspector's second spell, Desolate, also works on Roshan, so it's like, they should take it really fast. When first glance, you look at Team Spirit's lineup, it's like a pretty crappy Rosh lineup, but you should pretty good.
Well, they're buffing up their magical damage more. Even Puck, after getting the blink, goes in for a Veil of Discord. But they're losing all their outer buildings. Like, this tier 2 tower is dropping, and you haven't even used Phantasm yet from Pasha. And damn, there's one big Chaos Knight when you put Bloodlust on him.
It's really scary.
That's the thing nightmares are made of. You got a level 2 Phantasm ready to go, a 4-5 man lineup, and they're bearing down on top of Team Spirit's tier 3 tower. It's like Polarity also want to fight into this with a Blink Dagger on the OD. He's here to catch someone out of position. The Veil of Discord has already gone off on Pasha, but he's beating into the tower with the armor turned off at the moment. Dropping very, very low on life. Phobos also went in quite deep. They put a very defensive sentry ward in Team Spirit, so they can see if Phobos gets behind the lines. And they will repel Polarity, but damage was done to the tier 3. Are they gonna... Yep, Spectral Horn out. Wish Doctor be the sacrificial lamb. I don't think Lil... he gets away with his TP. So Wish Doctor dies for heavy damage onto a tier 3 tower trade.
Yeah, Team Spirit's doing what they're supposed to do. If you look at Polarity's lineup, they don't have a Blink initiation yet, except for OD. I disagree with OD being top in that push. If he doesn't show, and he sits at bottom, I'm sure they're gonna take it if I bottom. I don't know why they chose to exchange towers. Because, like, they gave Team Spirit, like, a bottom tower for no reason. And a kill. So, like, that's pretty... Team Spirit will obviously take that if they're losing. They might have Aegis, but honestly, it's an Aegis Spectre, which is, like, not even that strong yet. Because he only has face drums to earn. If Spectre is Radiance, then okay, but, like, you'd be like, alright, I don't want to fight, you know? Spectre, Radiance, Aegis. Like, that's hard. But if only it's drums, Aegis, you definitely should still fight.
Yeah, I can see that, but... Yeah. I always have Blitz's words ringing in my head whenever someone like starts talking about Dota with pushing tower, where he's just like, you've got to defend so many towers. Like, why lose a tower? Like, what do you really gain for it with the push?
Yeah. Especially look at Spectre, he is 4.3k gold. That means you're taking a fight with Spectre having 4k gold. So you look at the gold experience, it's like 5k gold lead, it's actually a 9k gold lead because Spectre's not spending his money because he's getting relic, you know?
Radiant's yeah. Top tower
is under so like, attack. It's actually a way bigger lead than you think it is.
But Illidan's still gonna have that cash. Like, that T1 tower is dropping pretty quickly on top lane. Phonix had the pressure and Polarity, if they do what they did before, it is gonna be a tower trade-off. They just go and push the tier 2 instead. Now Weaver, TPing to the north. And you'll actually end up denying that top tower.
It's not worth it for a deny. I mean, they could've got a trade. Oh, they got a kill middle. On gold black. Guess gold black should've ran away faster. He went back for the Manta, by the way, you were right.
Yeah, he did.
I was meant to have this. I was gonna say that the bottom tower trade was fine for Polarity, because if they lose their tier 2 tower, it's okay, because you look at bottom lane, Team Spirit doesn't have their tier 1 tower. And Polarity had a tier 1 tower up when they took the both towers top, which like is way better. But since they lost their tier 1 tower now it's evened out. Because if your tier 1 tower is up when the enemy team lost both their tier 1 and tier 2 towers, you have so much map control in the area of the map.
I'm still wondering how Polarity ended this game. Like, their ability to push high ground, obviously a lot of it comes down from Chaos Knight and all of his Chaos Knights. But Team Spirit is delaying this game more and more. Illidan's getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah, now it's the Radiant's Aegis. Now they want to fight, so they smoke. This is a good smoke. And they can show on a lot of heroes, because the Team Spirit, Polarity doesn't have enough catch. The only catch is the OD. But Odie's getting BKB too, so that's the timing. So right now, Polarity needs to hide. They should not fight right now. They should wait for Aegis to expire before they fight. And OD BKB before they fight. Yeah, that's the next timing.
They're still looking for the opening with a 3 smoke group. It looks like they just want to get one, but okay. So yeah, Polarity, they back out. They are going to hide back at their base. They have a smoke on the Ogre, but as you said, like, you still want to finish up that BKB over on the OD. And there goes your Aegis Immortal. So they waited out the timing on that. So there goes your advantage for Team Spirit.
They're playing very disciplined on Polarity. Look at this taking S5. They know that if they get caught out here right now, and then they die, although you don't BKB, the game suddenly looks really grim.
I'm not sure to work out just how much damage, like, in the later push of the game, who wins in a man fight? Chaos Knight or the Spectre?
Oh, Spectre will lose for sure.
Trying to think, because there's no way again to clean up all these illusions. Which is like, but if it's just one on one, like if it's just Illidan against the CK. Oh, Spectral Haunt, have they found one? Yeah, they did. The time lapse though from Phobos, he doesn't die. The dust will be triggered, so they see him. He's on the run, but support is rotating over. You got Iceberg in the middle of Polarity as they're coming over too, and now Illidan 3 seconds stun over on him. That's a 1-for-1 trade of Iceberg, still considering this, but consider it no more. You cannot take this fight.
It's worth it. I'll take that trade any day. Especially when you have tri-core lineup versus dual-core and you take a 1-for-1 carry trade. Really, way worth it.
Iceberg. That blink didn't get him down into the river.
Yeah, he's fine though.
Yeah. Afro's got no more maneuverability on him. But he's still got that 10-second BKB ready. Looks like Iceberg's trying to find some way to control him. The Aghanim's have to build for the puck.
Yeah, that's a good build, because he sees that everyone in Polarity is going BKBs, so it's a good way to like control them when they have BKBs. So what they have to do basically, Toby, is they have to force the BKBs from Polarity when puck ulti's on them, and then just run away, kite their BKBs, and kill them when their BKBs are over.
Does that even really work though? Because like when you got an OD on your field, like you've seen the Weaver tank through most of the damage anyway, so we just time lapse out. And the OD just imprisons himself, blink comes off cooldown, and then he's away to safety. I don't even like. I'm worried the Team Spirit don't even have the ability to force something like a BKB.
No, I don't think Team Spirit has the ability to win a team fight anymore at this point. Chaos Knight is too big, they fed him too much. Mm-hmm. I don't think they can win a team fight. I think the only way they're going to win this game is through splitting the map, splitting Polarity up, getting pickoffs all over the map with Nature's Prophet and Spectre on ulti and cooldown. And when the ulti was on cooldown, when they can't fight, they just split push. Because you look at Polarity's lineup, like you said earlier, like what's the high ground, you know? Yeah. They need to get kills. They need to get like kills outside the base to get a high ground push. And if they don't do that, I think that Team Spirit has like a decent chance to win this game.
It's got to keep those side lanes out, so it puts more pressure on the back of Funnik. But Funnik doesn't really have a split push build. Like, when you go for this Blink Dagger, your survivability increases as well as the Orc, but there's no Maelstrom. There's no quick way to push out the side lanes and get that split push going. There's no Agate Interceptor to create mass amounts of Treants, which keep Polarity on the back foot.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, I think he's working his way there slowly. With the Blink Dagger pickup, it kind of tells me that he wants to be more slippery in his split pushing, so he can TP and blink TP out and just be like really like hard to kill. Yeah. I hope he doesn't go sheepstick.
It makes a lot of sense because he just needs to have something to help his team find some picks. Because if they do it by themselves, even just with like, you need to always catch one person out, and that's only going to happen maybe once, maybe twice, that Polarity get caught in such a situation.
I think it's possible. Oh, Illidan, bot lane. Not good. This is not one.
He was hoping to come down and gank with the rest of his team. They had three guys, the Undying Puck and Disruptor, not Disruptor, Oracle, waiting to actually rotate over. Now Funnik looks towards mid lane. Phobos, Mr. No BKB, Silence, Orchid. They're going to get a trade-off.
Yeah, see, this is what they need to do. Minus Spectre died. That cannot happen.
You make it sound so simple. But now they get pressured on bottom lane too. These Chaos Knight illusions just... Okay, they're gonna time out. But it's still the bottom tower as well being taken out by the CK. So maybe a 1-for-1 here, a trade-off. But the CK now completes up his full BKB as well. Pasha is a beast. But you get your control factors awry, so... Hello, Agate Interceptor on the puck. They gave him a lot of farm in that mid lane just before that fight began. Bottom tower
is under attack. Pasha's so big. Look at him. So far.
I'm still wondering how you stop that. Apart from having maybe this, the second life through Aegis.
Yeah. I think Team Spirit has the ability to fight a Roche Pit just because they have Undying. I think they recognize that. I mean, this all stems back to, like, look at Undying's items, like, it's not really what you want.
He's trying to make it towards the Fog of War. He can't blink out, though, so he'll have to instantly AWP, waiting for the stun, Dream Call, but Pasha, he actually stood just far enough to the right that the Dream Call didn't connect on him.
The gem lasted less than 30 seconds. They just bought the gem and they lost it. It's like they just gave the gem to Polarity, and a kill, and Roshan, and Polarity's like, oh, I'll take that.
Life just got a lot harder for Team Spirit. And all of that was for one bounty rune. That's what the puck was actually making a play for, was for one bounty rune.
He blinked to the bounty rune too. That's the worst part about it. Oh. This is how they go high ground. You know, you get a pick off, you get Roche, shall we do it?
In 9 seconds time, they've also got Phantasm back up. And they rotate up towards the already injured tier 3 tower on top. Trigger the mana star to start with, Fortune's End or not. Phantasm is now up for Pasha, and they actually imprison up the Spectre. Goblack, well, he's got no tombstone to really help out. Illidan's going to get a stun, Maledicted, and there will be always one of fly saving grace on Illidan, but will even be enough? Pasha's being dragged back in. Remember, he's got the Aegis Immortal, and there goes the pop on the Spectre. Pasha, Iceberg wants to come out for him. Where's the damage? It's still not enough. Now they burn through the Aegis of the Immortal. Ogre will die too, and Illidan chasing down the supports. The Radiance Burn doesn't actually kill off the Witch Doctor at this point, as Afo turns on the BKB, down with Illidan. They'll move over to the next target, which is Iceberg, but he's able just to get himself away in time. But Goblack's also being hunted down by Phobos. The top racks will fall. The mid will probably follow because Pasha's still up, but with the buyback, now coming in from the Oracle, they're looking for more. That blink from Funnik, real nice timing. Gets himself away from the Reality Rift initiation of Pasha. But there's just so much of Pasha here in the mid lane. He's going to lose his teammates, however. And that's the Gem of True Sight, given back to Team Spirit. Except Iceberg still leaving it on the ground. Until Goblack will come up and pick it. Nope, Iceberg will drop his TP.
that was really good for Polarity, and then they stayed for an extra set of racks, which I have no clue why they did it, and they lost two kills in the gym. But still good for Polarity. Could have been better.
They got a lot of buybacks out. Well, maybe they lose more. Funnick. Well, okay. That damage is still pretty damn big. Funnick's still alive, however, and Pasha, he's not a healthy man. That last stack won't be enough. He's still just armlet toggling through the damage, and Gallblack, the trip multicast from Lil with the earned charge just to ensure it. Are able to find one kill, and Iceberg will just jaunt himself away to safety. The Funnick really wanted to get more out of that.
Yeah, it was really greedy from Funnick, especially when OD is spawning. Not the play. I mean, they got two kills, they got their jam back. The game was, you know, salvageable still, then that happened, and now, like, they lost the gem again? No, they have it. Puck.
Yeah. It was dropped back at the dire base, and, like, we still only lost, like, they just profit.
Yeah, the nightmare is real for Spectre. You get Radiance, you take a team fight, you lose the fight, you die, you buy it back, and you die again. It's like, that's the opposite of what you want to happen when you have Radiance.
Yeah.
Radiance, you want to win a team fight, not lose and die back.
Yeah, you get that Radiance, you win the team fight, then all of a sudden you got enough money for a straight Manta style. That's the play. But now he's walking around with 1,200 gold and he's falling behind even further. Chaos Knight has a Reaver on him, so Pasha's rapidly approaching that 3k mark. Okay, no, when he turns the armor on, he's actually got 3.1k, so he's already passed it. But if he gets a heart as well, Teen Spirit are just running out of damage.
Yeah, like I said, Chaos Knight was a really good pick. Teen Spirit picked 3 of the cores, and I mean, they don't know about the Spectre Batman Chaos Knight interaction. I didn't know Chaos Knight counter Spectre until I saw Batman do it. Honestly.
Well, maybe they learned a lesson in this game.
You know, surprisingly, Batman didn't get a team in this shuffle. I thought that was pretty surprising. I thought he was going to get a team for sure.
You thought he'd slip into one of the rosters as a trial? Maybe he doesn't want to play competitive.
No, he said he wanted to play competitive in the interview. I read it.
Alright.
It was...
Yeah. Some team manager out there. He can always go to the North American scene. Like, that's a lot of space there.
I mean, I guess that's the trend for now. It's Europeans moving to the harder region, you know? The top tier region.
Hey, that's where Veggie Esports is going.
Yeah, I mean, that's how you do it nowadays. I bet you everyone's gonna like put like spam like dumb memes on Twitch chat about how any Dota is shit, and then they get their beloved alliance eliminated by Complexity.
Gallblack, he is so gonna go down. Right, I'll help you out with that one in a second, man. But Iceberg still on the run. Looks like Polarity. Are they gonna chase further in? Not now. Yeah, but the simple answer is for you, man. Your American scene is kind of crap. But you've got a couple of great teams out there that show that you've got top talent. And that's where the American scene, like, looks good with the players, but from, like, tournaments that are organized there and organizations which are based there, BTS is kind of like the only big group that does much out of them.
Yeah, but now there's going to be 3 North American teams that are, like, top tier, Secret, EG, and Complexity.
Should have classed Secret as American now, don't we? Iceberg, oh, they're going in deep. There's just so many illusions down with CK and the Spectral Horn being triggered. Apo going to go into his BKB. He's looking for any kind of target to attack. And it's not to steal that intel so he can pair himself to the ultimate. Oracle's already down for the count. And actually, in the end of that imprisonment, Apo, he gets the kill on Gallblack. And Team Spirit, it's like they've lost too many racks now. The heart's over on Pasha, he really doesn't care about any damage the Team Spirit does. This game is good, this game is golf, this game is over.
I'm sure Chaos Knight could drop like his heart and still win the game.
Yeah, there it is, GG, well played. Team Spirit will call it.
Yeah, I think this is, we're chalking up the draft, boys.
Yes.
Chuck one up to the draft.
But it's something too which you could see coming. They ran the almost exact same draft, obviously without Ogre and Witch Doctor. The Weave was a little bit different, but it's the synergy they had between the CK as well as the OD, which Polarity have just been exploiting time and time again. They first pick up OD in the phase, and they get Chaos Knight into the second phase, and it was allowed to come through.
I really didn't like the Witch Doctor. I mean, the Oracle pick. I would rather a Lion and Sand King, or like something like that. They need a Sand King. Sand King's instant stun was Weaver for kills, so Weaver won't get so far on top because you have instant stun, and then you have the Sand King Blink Dagger. You have no space to get Sand King Blink Dagger because you have a Puck middle, and then Sand King just kills illusions in the mid game too. It's like super good with Veil.
It was a rough game for Team Spirit to put nicely. Polarity, one game up. They may advance themselves through into the next round. We'll find out if that will be the case as Game 2 will be coming up after this short break. And we have really short breaks here at Epicenter. Like, our breaks, one of them lasted a grand total of 30 seconds. So stay tuned. We will be back.